Assuming you win, what would take place then? Would, you know, at the end of this time here in San Francisco, is the judge expected to make a ruling right away, or is it going to be months down the line, years down the line? And if he does side with Fluoride Action Network and the plaintiffs, would that immediately be the end of water fluoridation, or, you know, what comes afterwards?
So I don't know when the judge will make the decision. I expect it will be relatively soon at the close of trial, so within weeks or maybe a month or in somewhere in that realm. If the court finds that fluoridation presents an unreasonable risk in the form of neurotoxicity, then the EPA will be mandated by law to initiate a rulemaking proceeding to eliminate that risk, okay? So the one thing is EPA may appeal the judge's ruling, in which case we'd have some appellate procedure here in the court system. But assuming we win on appeal, then the EPA has to eliminate the risk posed by fluoridation chemicals in the drinking water. And, you know, it's kind of obvious. How do you eliminate the risk created by adding fluoridation chemicals to drinking water? Well, you just don't add them to the water. You stop adding them. And that's what we certainly are hoping EPA will do.